Today we are going to talk about a piece of Taoist magic, and this has to do with the Taoist ceremonial calendar. When you go look at the Taoist calendar, you see that the 16th of October in the moon calendar, or this year 2018, it's the 23rd of November, it is the celebration of the water god. And the water god is a very interesting figure. Today it is one day before the water god day. When I'm recording this video, and I hope I get it uploaded in time for you to see this, so that you can still participate in the ceremony as it is. In the Water God Day, you normally pray for luck in your coming time. I will tell you a little bit more about it, and I tell you why. In Taoist magic, there are three different gods. There's the god of earth, the god of heaven, and the god of water. And these three gods together, they are the base ingredients for the performance of Taoist ritual magic. And this is to change your future. And when you want to have things done for your country, for your village, for your family, or something like this, then this is the combination of gods that you have to send messages to. And these messages that you send them are important to get things done. These are the officials that move files around in the heavenly bureaucracy and make sure that the respective gods that require to get them will receive them. So these are important. The water god is also associated with Xuanwu. And Xuanwu, as you know, has become Zhenwu. So the water god is specifically important for Wudang Taoists. Xuanwu is the god of the north and is associated with water. And the Xuanwu is associated with a symbol of turtle and snake. And turtle and snake, as they're intertwined, they're a little bit similar, like the dragon symbol. So this is actually one of the reasons why I point this out.
These are the I know somebody.
The water god is specifically important because of his symbolism. He is associated as riding on a dragon, and the dragon is flying through the sky and is the symbol for rain. So as such, it is a symbol of fertility. The rain dragon lives in a palace under the rivers, under the lakes. So when you go fishing, you have to pray to the water god to make sure that the water is not going to eat you. And in China especially, this was very important because there were a few rivers, and still people have to work all the time to manage the water, the water god. Symbolism of the water god, like I said, is rain, and that is fertility. And that means the future. And the future always depends on the past. In the I Ching, they say there's two ways to progress to the future, and the one way to progress to the future is by breaking things down, like in a revolution, or by any form of marketing disruption and stuff like this, and then to destroy everything that was before and to create something new, and then you don't know exactly what you're getting, and in many cases that is later regretted. What is the wise way, the second way, according to the I Ching, is the gradual change, where you slowly nudge things into the right direction. This is the way how governments usually try to manage things, and how people in their lives also try to manage things. And at the moment when you have a burnout, this is no longer possible, and you crash and you create a revolution. So that's a forced change. What I wanted to say with this is that these changes are partly influenced by your thinking about your future, but also by thinking about your past. So you can't do without considering your past, what is behind you, what you have done, and what is the consequences of that. And the water god is specifically important for that, because the water god actually determines your fate for the coming years at the 23rd of November, the 16th of October in 4716 in the Chinese calendar. I just had to check the number for a moment. The interesting thing is that the 23rd of November is Earth Day. this year, the 23rd of November is Earth Day, because the calendars, they overlap, and they don't overlap every day, every year in the same way. But this is an Earth Day, and the Earth Day is important because it requires water to fertilize. So you see, water is a very important part of things, and karma in that sense is like water. If your karma is bad, the water is dry, so it doesn't fertilize. If the karma is good, it is like wet water, so the karma is fertilizing your life. So the fate of the next year is going to be determined. This is around the period when the winter starts, and it has to be determined how you're going to go through your winter period. So you can say traditionally that the determining of the fate is about how did you do last year with your harvest? Did you get all the things that you needed to be able to manage it through the winter and the spring so that you can eat food and not die during the winter and not starve from cold because you don't have enough wood and stuff like this to burn your fires? So now you have a little bit of an idea. And now I'm going to tell you also how to make use of this. First of all, of course, you have to see what is your weak spots about the last year. What did you do wrong? This is a little bit similar like determining the horoscope for the next year, which I do around the Chinese New Year every year. When you are determining your fate, you have to see what is the net results of my last year. And then based on the weaknesses from the last year, you have to pray by writing on a paper what you need, what kind of salvation you need. You write it on a paper, you tie it up, and you tie it to a stone. And then during praying, burning incense, you drop it in the water so that it goes underwater and can go with the fishes to the water god. Another aspect of the water god, which is very interesting and important maybe, is the association with water in Tai Chi Chuan, because you're supposed to move like water. So you are a little bit like a water god at the moment when you practice Tai Chi Chuan. And when you are practicing Tai Chi Chuan, you are practicing this on the land of the three gods, Earth God and the Heaven God. So this is the space around you, is the heaven, of course. So at any time when you practice Tai Chi Chuan, you're involved with these three messengers. And there's other things that you can do to make sure that your karma is good. That is, make sure physically and mentally you are doing right things. You are a moral person, and you don't do bad things. You don't have a job that is harming people. You don't behave bad to your wife or husband or your children. You give a good education to your children, and you make sure that their chances in life are very high to be happy and successful. And this is, of course, not for everybody the same. Important is that you're a good citizen to your country, that you contribute to your community. I hope this was very useful to you, and that you have any benefit from it. At least I hope it is interesting to you. I am planning to do more of these issues on the calendar, the Chinese calendar, for important ceremonies, and help you this way to develop a Taoist life if you can.